Your question is fx is equal to 3x minus 1 for f belongs to the real number, gx is equal to 3 by 2x minus 4 for x belongs to real number, x is not equal to 2. Here they was find the expression for f inverse of x and g inverse of x, and secondly show that the equation g inverse of x is equal to f inverse of x is equal to g inverse of x has two real roots. Now understand this, what they have told. So first we have to find out f inverse and g inverse. So now they have given this. So first they have given f x is equal to 3x minus 1, and here they have given gx that is equal to 3 by 2x minus 4. So for inversion what we have to do, just we have to take fx as y is equal to 3x minus 1. Here it will be y is equal to 3 by 2x minus 4. Now replace y with x and x with y. So it will be what? You can see. So y is here, that means it will become x and this will become y. Minus 1, here also same, x is equal to 3 by 2y minus 4. Now, again we have to rearrange as y only. So you can see here, 3y is equal to x plus 1. So what is your y? Y is equal to x plus 1 by 3. So this is nothing but your f inverse. This is your f inverse. Now comes here, again we have to do the same thing. What we have to take? Just multiply this. So it will be 2xy minus 4x. That is equal to 3. Okay, now bring this to this side. It will be 2xy, or you can take x as common also here. So don't take x as common, just bring this to this side. So that is equal to 3 plus 4x. So what is your y? So y is nothing but 3 plus 4x by 2x. So this y is known as your g inverse. So this is your g inverse. We have solved this. Now what they have told, this f inverse is equal to g inverse. That means this is equal to this. So what we will get? X plus 1 by 3 is equal to 3 plus 4x by 2x. Now go for the cross multiplication. So here it will be what? 2x into x is 2x square plus 1 into 2x is 2x, that is equal to 3 into 3 is 9 plus 3 into 4 is 12x. Bring everything to your left side. It will be 2x square and 12x here become minus 12x. Minus 12x plus 2x is minus 10x. And this will become minus 9. That gives you 0. Now, what they have told? They have told, show that the equation has two real roots. The roots are to be real. How? We know quadratic formula, that is your discriminant. The discriminant should be what? It should be greater than 0. That means b square minus 4ac should be greater than 0. Now, so So if you write the standard form of quadratic equation, what is that? That is your a x square plus b x plus c, that gives you 0. That means a is 2, b is minus 10, c is minus 9. Now substitute this value here, we should get greater than 0. So you can see b is minus 10, minus 10 square, minus 4 into a, a is 2, and c, c is minus 9. So that is equal to, we can say it's minus 10 square is 100, and minus into minus is plus, it comes 4 into 2 is 8, 8 into 9 is 72. That is equal to 172. So 172 is greater than 0. Therefore it contains two real and distinct root. Two real and distinct root. Like this we have to do it.